Good afternoon, Sarah. We're in a tiny little hamlet 5 kilometres from Pedrogao Grande and an absolutely gorgeous stone-built villa.
Yeah, it's unusual these days now. Although we used to have many, many stone houses, it's now a pure delight to find one, especially one like this, which is quite quirky. It's also quite large. We've got 5 bedrooms and 5 bathrooms, or 4 bathrooms and 1 WC. We'll show you the layout, obviously, as we go through the video. It's also got an absolutely beautiful garden. And location-wise, it's very peaceful. We're just, maybe you can get the views that way. Can you get from the corner I'm stood on? I'm not sure if you can get it. I can get the depth of the mountain in the distance. You might have to get past that outbuilding there. But it's really very, very peaceful. We did just try and stop. We had one woman walk by, so no cars yet. So I think we're going to come through the front door. Oh no, we're going through the side door, are we?
Yeah, I think we shall go through the vehicle access, isn't it?
Yeah. So, but the facade, as you can see, beautifully done, pointed up, rendered at the bottom. Walled space, you're not directly on the road. Okay, so this area here, now I understand. So there's a woodshed there, that's a significant area in its own right. That's locked at the moment. So yes, this area belongs to the property. So this is your drive-in entrance, if you should need to, or your parking spot really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Water's there.
Yeah, I think the courtyard's actually so nice. You'd keep that just as a parking area and have this.
Yeah, well, actually, it's there,
yeah,
isn't it?
You wouldn't use it, would you?
No. So as we come in, now, should we do a brief explanation? I think we wanted to take through the gardens, but I mean, you can take in some details, like, look at that, it's gorgeous. This is a storage room. We'll come back and we'll just do the little details as we go through. This is a cottage, a self-contained one-bedroom cottage. These stairs lead here. Look, you've got a curved stone wall. They lead up to the bedrooms and bathrooms on that floor. There's obviously the huge terrace that you can see.
Yeah, fabulous balcony and terrace.
We've got the courtyard here, but actually, the garden is so delightful. We're going to follow the path.
Okay.
So this is where I went exploring earlier, friends. So we've got the old bread oven here. And just look at the flowers. It's such a delight to see a garden so beautifully maintained. There are lemons everywhere.
Oh, look at those lemons.
I'll wait till you get down the bottom because look, they're everywhere. I went to start picking them up and then I thought I'd just have to, maybe I'll leave with the sack. But yes, it is really pretty. Another, we'd call it an area, but it's not an area, but we've got a paved area for sitting. And I guess, should we just go right down to the bottom?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a pleasure to be in. Yeah, such a well-kept garden, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got a pony tunnel. We've got a shade area created by the bean plants. A lovely weeping willow. And then as you come down, I've got books and all sorts of information about planting a dry garden. Never actually got around to doing it. But we've got the different types of pampas grasses here. So this purple one, and then there's another absolutely enormous one behind there. So this is an orange or a tangerine. Well established, absolutely full of fruit, that one. I'd say we've probably got about 10 olives or 15. And then look at the size of this. It's a beast. And there's one of these, which is normal, look. Gorgeous. So these are made for dry gardens. You don't need a lot of water. Look at this baby. You can tell which way the wind blows, can't you? That way.
You can.
Look at it. And then we have a proper wide entrance if you wanted to come up here. So here we have at the bottom of the garden, there's a raised level here, but what we've got is quite large double gates. So if you wanted to get a caravan or something in here.
A tractor.
Tractor. Well, that, anyway.
Yeah, yeah, it's not the kind of garden for
No, no. I mean, look at this, yucca. I mean, it's just enormous. But anyway, you have vehicle access here. So if you're someone who's got a caravan, you could bring it in. Or someone that's got a van, you can bring it in. You've got parking. You've got parking at the rear of the garden and parking at the front. So as we...
These are just enormous, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, it's gorgeous.
They're absolutely
it's a beast.
Fabulous, yeah.
Respect is given in its own right for these enormous plants. And then we've got another lemon tree. And if you just look at all the lemons on the floor.
He's clearly not a gin and tonic drinker.
Well, I was just thinking about, he's a secret, what is it?
Lemonade drinker. Yeah.
All right. No, I'm not going to think of that.
No, let's not go there. I'm just going into this little bit here.
You might have to find a clip. Right, hang on. Sorry, I'm behind the lemon tree. I'm coming back. Yeah, loads of lemons.
Yeah.
Right, so let's... So as we go up here, more pampas and a compost. We've got vines going completely bonkers up there on the fence.
Yeah, hang on, let me just catch up with you a little bit.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Very mature olive trees as well.
Olives. Can I slow down? Okay. As we come, we'll follow this way, I think. We have here, so he's got a polytunnel. Do you want to see the young olives? We haven't got many on our trees at the moment. I think they don't like us because we didn't prune them last year. Got a Nespera here. The willow's looking fabulous. There's a polytunnel there. There's a water container. And then, if you come and look here, this way here, look, we've got the perfect shade. Go on underneath. Given by the beans. Isn't that a great place to sit?
Yeah, that is a lovely place
to sit. They made teepee for the kids once. Do you remember? We had beans, and they were little, smaller at that point. So that's the main garden. Loads of shade going on to that. It's just gorgeous.
Yeah. I'm just going to get a little bit more of that there. Some of the detailing on these little stone walls is just fabulous, aren't they? Really.
Lots of them.
Yeah.
Endless. It's a sheet stone. It's the closest sort of thing you get here to Welsh slate. Very, very nice indeed. Oh, I said it. I've got a pair of bongos that make up for it. I'm not joking.
No.
They are a pair of bongos. So, where do you think we should go first?
Now, bongos are drums. They're not drums.
We'll find out afterwards. rather than do a display. So, shall we go into the cottage?
Yeah, I think so. Well, let's do this courtyard. I mean, we're here, aren't
we? The courtyard in Elf. I mean,
it is.
Okay, let's explain doors. Shall we?
Okay.
Without going in them, we'll explain doors. This leads into the master bedroom.
Okay.
En suite, laundry room, WC, into the main lounge and diner.
Yeah.
Which walks through into the kitchen. So everything comes out onto the courtyard. Hello, pussycat. And then we have the steps up there. Let's do the independent cottage first.
Okay. Put my light on.
Yeah, let me check for lights. Come in. And the house is very quirky. I love the detail because it's quite rustic. And so you've got your full kitchen here if you turn around. You've kept the stone. You've got a dining table there, built-in bench, storage. Wood burner, which is interesting. Well, essential. and because that stack pipe goes up through the bedroom upstairs.
So that'll keep the bedroom warm as well.
Yeah. And just adding the triangle in the door just to get a bit more light.
Yeah.
You know, little things make a difference, don't they? Now they've got staircase that we had in our old house.
Yeah, the old solar steps.
Yeah, which I did 2 pregnancies going up and down these. Carrying babies, and it was fine.
As long as you lead with the right, with the correct foot, they're never a problem.
Yeah, start with your right. See, it's the same one. Start with your right.
Start with your right foot.
He's got a safety. He's got a safety thing. So you pull yourself up.
We never thought about that, did we?
No.
Oh, I won't.
Yeah, not straight up my skirt, if you don't mind.
Now we can. Now we can safely turn the camera.
Right. Okay.
Ooh.
Yeah. They are a little bit. But yes, we only had stairs went in when I was up until 8 months pregnant. I was on a ladder.
The good old days.
Good old days, darling. So, bathroom upstairs and one good sized bedroom. Nice sized bedroom. We've got a bit of good stuff, Clint, on the wall.
Yeah, it's a big double, isn't it?
Yep, slack pipe. But that's going to keep you lovely and warm. And of course, I had to open this door. Find out if you ever feel like leaping, this is where to go.
Yeah.
This is, you have to come and see now.
Oh, right.
Because it's a staircase coming up, but there's no barrier there.
Right, okay.
Yeah, but it's a staircase from the outside. It's very sweet.
Okie dokie. You either put a staircase in or make that a window.
You just put a little railing there, don't you? You can open
you could do that, or make a balcony.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Whatever.
So this is a good...
There's a naked woman on the wall.
Yeah, no, very nice size. Oh, no, it's a very good size. Oh, there's shelving at the top there as well. Maybe not this, but there's room for storage shelf, at the top there.
Okay, interesting to note that...
what are you filming?
Couple that
you're filming a wall.
Yeah, I'm filming a wall. The couple that lived here before used to stay in here while the main house was rented out.
Okay. Okay. She wrote, I don't need you falling down these
with
a camera in one hand. Although, actually, my client yesterday, I'm waiting for the video to send me because she was videoing the house, which was completely different properties to this, and she fell through the floor. So I'm waiting for her to send me the clip where she actually disappears and probably swears quite a lot. I'm waiting for that little bit of excitement to come through. Along with an offer, I hope. Right. I think we should probably do the main house and then come back.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Just lead on.
Lead on, my dear.
It is absolutely delightful, the inside of the
property. I love it. I'd love living here.
Yeah.
Completely different to my own house, and I love it.
Yeah.
So, here we are in the kitchen. And we have, actually, look at the exposed there. That's very old. We've got a bit, almost. I thought that was brick then, but it's not.
It's all stone.
I thought it was old brick.
Yeah.
So very nice. We've got the shades down to keep it cool.
Yeah.
But we've got a large cooker, so you've got space for a large cooker. Nice wooden work surfaces.
Yeah, it is lovely.
I like that. Dinner choices, take it or leave it. Oh, I needed to borrow that. double sink, fridge, freezer, storage underneath on top. Nice, very rustic.
Yeah, it's just a real well thought out kitchen, to be honest.
Yeah, it's lovely. Oh, and the dog can open the door. Nearly. 13.
Oh.
What's that noise?
Nothing. Doesn't matter.
I thought it was your stomach for a minute. It's an aeroplane. Right. Okay, and we're coming into what's the main dining and lounge area.
Yeah.
Personally, I particularly love the very, very funky burner here. So.
Yeah, that stackpipe.
They created the character in this property with a very nice sense of style.
It's a work of art, isn't
it? It's a work of art. I love it. Yeah. Old radiator, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's been handmade. Yeah. And but if we're going to look at this beam.
Well, I will do.
Oh, sorry, am I jumping the gun? I'm excited about you again.
You're getting a bit of ahead of the game.
I know. Shall I do it again?
Yeah.
There we go. So, yeah,
no, it's just full of
beams, aren't they?
Yeah, it's just full of rustic charm, isn't it? It's just gorgeous.
It's all been treated.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
So, from here, so the house flows through this way. And then we've got little features. So you've got the tile stone, and then there's a bit where you've got the slate left. And then tiles again. It's just little features everywhere. So here you've got the WC. which is just for obviously general use. But we don't need to spend too long in there.
Sometimes I need to spend quite a lot of time in WCs.
Well, the next one's better, right. Then we've got... No, we don't.
No.
Now we have a laundry room.
We do have a laundry room.
Okay, you don't need to spend a lot of time in there either.
No, but people need to see them, so...
Probably not in people's laundry. Right, okay. I've lost the bathroom.
Yes.
Anyway, come into the master bedroom. So we've got lovely shelving there. Again, beautiful features, stone, wood. Ah, another burner. So that's going up into a bedroom upstairs. Window, which is completely shaded by the kiwis. Oh, I love this garden.
Yeah.
Okay, and then here. So this is a really lovely size bedroom. If you wanted to put built-in wardrobe, there's space to do it. You've got tons of space. And it's en suite and a good-sized bathroom as well with a shower.
Yeah, really good-sized bathroom and shower. Yeah, excellent.
So from here, well, I guess we go back out to the courtyard, don't we?
Well, that would be one. I mean, I think it's important to mention that, I mean, you could just live on this one floor as a couple, couldn't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, everything's on this one floor.
Yeah. You could, I mean, this is very much, you've got a nice big space here.
Yeah, lovely big space.
You're blinding me slightly. But you could rent out the rooms upstairs. And then there's the cottage, which is self-contained. So you could do bed and breakfast, couldn't you? It's prime for bed and breakfast.
Yeah, I just love the archway. I know we've done this. I just love that archway there. And yeah, come round and then access to... This rather lovely balcony and terrace are not these equally lovely stone stairs. It is absolutely gorgeous, all of it.
Yeah.
And I
can't
really
believe. See, Paul wanted a modern house. He built a house out of polystyrene, and look at him now. He's falling back in love with the stone.
Yeah.
Marvellous.
I never fell out of love with stone. I just didn't. I wanted something different.
I know. No, our house is amazing.
Yeah.
But it's just different style. I wish my plant like this would just grow. Everyone else's grows.
Yeah.
So, beautiful terrace. Nice views. Incredibly peaceful.
It is outrageously peaceful. I mean, we've had one aeroplane and one pedestrian.
One aeroplane and one person.
Yeah, passed the whole time we're here. No cars at all.
One will come.
Yeah.
Right.
But, yeah, just lovely countryside. Absolutely stunning.
So private. We're not overlooked.
Now, there's the little rental cottage, or you could live in that and rent this whole house out as holiday lets. You get very good money for renting this out.
Yeah.
And if that house over there, a little TLC is perfectly nice, home in its own right, anyway.
But like you said, you live downstairs, and with these, you do bed and breakfast.
Yeah.
Cottage. So, this one here has two bedrooms. So this good size double.
Yeah.
Two of light coming in. You've got the double doors and three windows.
Yeah, there's room for two good singles, emperor bed, whatever you want.
Yeah.
Isn't there? It can make a twin room. Big double.
Yeah. So this can be closed both sides here.
Yeah.
This can be open. It's another house with lots of doors. Where was the last one I went to? It had eight doors. Oh, there's another double bedroom here of a very good size. And then a good size bathroom here. And again, we've got the stack pipe coming up from that main beautiful wood burner downstairs. So that's going to keep this place warm. Up on this level in the winter.
Yeah, I mean, this is an adequate double,
absolutely,
isn't it?
Yeah, perfect space for a wardrobe in the corner there. Plenty of room.
I think there was a wardrobe there by the look of it at one point.
The bathroom's large. And both bedrooms can independently get to the bathroom and get outside. So this is a two-bedroom one part. But the real one. 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom part. And actually, I can clearly see that there's a loft hatch. So you've obviously got storage above you. And then we come round to the end part of the property.
Yeah, I love
these. Actually, all this is, it must have been woodwork. It's all made out of a reclaimed wood. Beautiful. Oh. I'm not allowed in.
Yes, you are. You're always allowed in.
One boot.
There is a random welly.
That's not a welly.
Is it not?
No, let's not start talking wellies. Right. Lovely big room.
Really, really lovely big room.
And lovely ensuite.
Yeah, all the bathrooms are well sized, aren't they?
They are really good sizes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything you need. So up here, you've got ensuite, main room, access onto the balcony. Next door, 2 rooms, 1 bathroom. So it's perfect for bed and breakfast, isn't it? Because you can eat for them downstairs.
Absolutely.
Or it's just a big family. Fine.
Yeah.
So, where are we going now? Have we done it all?
I think we have.
I think that seems to be quite quick for rather a lot of house.
I don't think we've missed anything.
No. Where do we summarise?
Well, I think it's over here.
Up here, I think.
Yeah.
I fancy staying, to be honest.
Well.
Yeah.
He'd probably let you. He'd probably let you, but me and the kids would miss you.
Any one of them asked earlier if we could just all have separate houses. Okay, so in summary, I think you can tell we've got a beautiful character property. It's large. You know, we have altogether 5 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms. Huge terrace up on this level. Big views, wide, long-distance views all around, actually. Gorgeous garden. Independent 1-bedroom cottage. Also with independent access. And downstairs is a very good-sized lounge kitchen, lounge dining room. And then the kitchen, again, it's separate, isn't it? But it's just through a doorway. And everything goes out onto this lovely courtyard down here.
Yeah, I mean, this place is surrounded by forests and river beaches. And
absolutely.
Isn't there? Some of the best river beaches in Portugal are within shouting distance of here. Castanheira de Pedra's not far from here as well.
Nope.
Which has got all the wave
machines. You've got Praia da Rocha, how much of it's got the wave.
Yeah, you've fast access to the IC8, which will get you to the seaside very quickly as well.
Well, covered, while Paul couldn't remember the name of the beach. For, I think Praia de Pedrogao is our closest
river beach
across. Yeah. Which would about an hour, hour and 10.
Oh, well, no, yeah. Yeah, maximum. Yeah, not more than an hour.
But you've got loads of river beaches within 20 minutes.
Yeah.
You're in river beach there.
The beach in actual time is probably Praia de Osso de Baleia. So there
now
you go.
Now we're going to have to look all of these up later.
But yeah, Figueira de Foz, if you want something. You know,
go to the casino.
Yeah,
there's
the casino. Away from the casino. If you've got a gambling habit, don't move here.
Right, okay, let's get back in the book. So we've got this beautiful courtyard down here, and then if you were renting it out, so obviously you are doing bed and breakfast and you had a load of people here, you've got tons of garden down there where you can go and get your own privacy and seclusion.
Absolutely.
And it works very, very well as a family home or as a rental business. So I think you should look at the price, see that it's a good price and it's a very nice area. And we hope to see you soon and
Sunday. Do let us know what you think in the comments.
Sorry?
I was saying to the viewers, let us know what you think in the comments. And do like and subscribe.
Okay. You send it for all with this time. Bye.